What's up, guys? Cherubim Church from holytext.org, and today we're going to look at a video interviewing an alien. Now, the video is not real itself. I think it looks very CGI. It's not real. It has a lot of movie effects in there, and it just doesn't look real, and it's not real. But that is not what's important. What's important is actually what the alien figure is saying. And we're going to take a look at that, and then we're going to talk about what it says. So, take a look.
Okay, we're recording. State, planet of origin? Roost. Okay, yesterday you told us you traveled, and I quote, thousands of light years to get here. Gosh. Tell us the truth. So I take it aliens took over our future, right? So you're human. Okay, so you evolved from us. So what are you doing here now? How? Okay, so how about we concentrate on your time? Try me. Wait, so you know the meaning of life? What's the difference? So you know how the universe is created? So you think God? Okay, illuminate us. What happens when we die? Okay, so let me get this straight. There's no death, and we all experience each other's lives, right? Okay, so how was the universe created, and why is it so perfectly made for us? Moving on. Okay, so why do we destroy ourselves with nuclear war? Can you be more specific, please? Right. Okay, one last thing. What about morality? What are you basing your morality on?
So that was the clip, and as we can see, straight off the bat, it just says, you know, God is an illusion, it's not real, it's a superstition. The world is destroyed by religious dogma. So basically, it's trying to explain, they have read the Bible, right? Satan and all his angels and all the demons and everyone. They've read the Bible. They know exactly what's going to happen. So they're using that to their advantage by saying, oh, this is going to happen. There are going to be a lot of uprisings, a lot of wars, and, you know, rumors of wars and stuff like this. And then the Antichrist is going to come, and he's going to start persecuting Christians. And there's going to be a lot of fighting and stuff like that. And it's going to be, oh, we have to cleanse the religious, the fundamentalists, especially the Christians, because we're the danger. I mean, we're the only ones with the truth. Buddhism, they're going to fall for this Antichrist. Islam, they're going to fall for the Antichrist. Judaism, they're going to fall for the Antichrist. Who isn't going to fall for the Antichrist? The Christians, because we know he's the Antichrist. And they're not going to be secretive about it. They're gonna say, they're gonna make jokes, you know, haha, they believe this guy is the Antichrist, religious dogma, blah blah blah, when in reality he's really us from the future or whatever, you know. And what's so interesting about this video, it's very, very accurate with what it's saying, because I've looked at a lot of interviews from people that have been abducted by aliens, and I uploaded a video of two girls. And they said the exact same thing. They said that the aliens were us from the future, and that they, you know, evolved, and they just, it's so ridiculous. It's so ridiculous. It's so easy to disprove evolution. If you want to know more about that, you can go to icr.org, or you can check out Kent Hovind's videos on evolution. I became a Christian, and 3 days after I prayed to God about showing me the truth of evolution, because I still believed in it, because I had nothing else. I didn't even read the Bible or anything. I just knew that Jesus was God. And I thought, you know, he created it with evolution and stuff. And 3 days after I prayed to God about that, I found Kent Hovind. And a couple hours later, I was no longer believing in evolution. I had my mind open, I accepted whatever God wanted me to know, that was it. And I think that a lot of people should learn about this stuff, about the alien deception, because that's how I got saved. I got saved by being attacked by what I thought were aliens. And it was crazy. And it was, I have that on my testimony video. And they're actual physical beings. They're not just demon spirits. They're, what I believe they are doing is that they're creating bodies, or the Illuminati or whoever is creating bodies for the spirits to indwell. So they make them look like aliens. Or what we know as aliens. And they indwell these bodies and they become physical. But they're not, they have some kind of technology that makes them go through walls, and they can telepathically communicate. So they're going to attribute all those things to evolution, you know. And the mark of the beast might be, hey, you want to be like us? You want to evolve? You want to evolve past this God nonsense, this religion nonsense, this Christianity nonsense? Come. We're going to give you a little mark, and you will be enlightened. And the word he used there was illuminate, so it's very satanic, very Luciferian, and it's very, very obvious what they're doing, and, you know, to a Christian. And when, if someone tests the DNA of these things, the alien DNA, they're going to find a lot of similarities between human beings, us, and them. And that's going to be another proof that they're related to us and they come from far, far away and all this nonsense. So that's the deception, I believe, that's going to happen. I don't know exactly how it's going to play out, but I read a lot about people channeling spirits, the enlightened ones, the masters and all that, which are fallen angels, I believe. And they've been saying that a fourth of the human race has to be killed for their little paradise on Earth to take place and to stop all these wars and religious dogma, as this creature said. So it's very interesting also that it's a very high production video. Very high production. It's not just some kind of mask, but it's CGI. It's really well done. Has all the effects, you know, lighting is well done, everything. So it's interesting. Someone spent a lot of money to do this little clip. Or they were extremely good with, you know, 3D programs and animation and stuff, and they wanted to make that. I believe there's a bigger agenda to this. I believe they put out videos on YouTube and stuff like that to prepare the world in more ways than one. They obviously know the internet, the TV, magazines, stories, books, ebooks, everything. They pump out all this, all these fantasies and lies, and eventually when it happens, it's not going to be that surprising to people. We've been with you since the age of time, you know, and whatever. It's just, it's going to be big. It's going to be really a big deception. And if you're not a Christian, you're falling for it. Most people are going to fall for it. I know I would fall for it easily. I would easily fall for it. I see something that's out of this world. I still remember what it's like, you know, being an atheist. There's no purpose to life. Everything sucked. I had no real mission in life. My purpose was to make money and get a family, and that was it. And then I would die. So if something like this comes along, huge amounts of people are going to fall for it. They're not going to think straight. It's not going to be... it's going to be very emotional too. Oh, there is something to life. I don't have to fear death. There's no such thing as death. He is me and I am him and all this crap. So the real truth is Jesus Christ. He is God. He died for you on the cross. He was buried and he rose again 3 days later. And if you simply trust that he did that for you to pay for all your sins so you could go to heaven, you're saved. You're going to heaven. Doesn't matter what else you believe. You might believe the rapture is before the tribulation, after the tribulation. You might believe the rapture happened 60 billion years ago. It doesn't matter. As long as you believe that Jesus did that for you, you're going to heaven. And that's the most important thing. So that's really what I wanted to show you guys. Very interesting little video. God bless you guys. This has been Cherubim Church from holytext.org. Take care, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.